He said the acting Secretary of Defense, Patrick Shanahan, who has done a wonderful job, has decided not to go forward with his confirmation process so that he can devote more time to his family. I thank Pat for his outstanding service and will be naming Secretary of the Army Mark Esper to be the new acting Secretary of Defense. I know Mark and have no doubt he will do a fantastic job. And Caitlin, I know that we are just getting wind of this, and you're there at this, what is supposed to be the official kickoff rally for President Trump later today. But just give it, this I suspect does not come as too much of a surprise to you. Tell us a little bit about the context around this, finding out that the Secretary of Defense, who's been acting, Patrick Shanahan, since Jim Mattis resigned. Tell us about this fact that now this is no longer going forward.
Yeah, Patrick Shanahan has been the acting defense secretary since James Mattis resigned last fall, left in December. Then Patrick Shanahan took over. He's this former Boeing executive, and for so long he languished in that role as acting defense secretary. And he and the chief of staff, Mick Mulvaney, pushed the president to nominate him as the defense secretary because they said it was affecting his abilities to carry out his job to the best of his ability. So then you saw the president several weeks ago announce that, yes, he did intend to nominate Patrick Shanahan as the permanent defense secretary. But Brianna, we raised questions in recent weeks because that nomination never became official. You have to actually send the paperwork up to Capitol Hill, and there had been questions about whether his background check had been completed, what essentially was tying up his nomination, and there had been speculation that there was a chance it could be withdrawn. Now, of course, we should note that the president privately has been talking very highly of Patrick Shanahan, has been praising him lately. So the question now that Patrick Shanahan has told the president he's decided to withdraw is just another name essentially that we've seen on a list of names coming out of this administration of people that the president has wanted to put in positions, but then later, because they're not sure about their nomination or confirmation process, have had to withdraw. Now, Mark Esper, the guy that the president now says he's going to nominate to be the defense secretary, is someone that people we've reported that have been pushing the president to pick him when he was debating whether or not he should pick Patrick Shanahan. So that will be welcome news to the people who have been pushing him. But of course, Brianna, you cannot ignore the very serious backdrop that is happening in all of this, which is, of course, the escalating tensions with Iran that are happening and all of that. And that is why the president and his allies are going to be pushing him to get someone in that position and get them nominated.
Yeah, as you're sending more troops to the region for a defensive posture, the idea that there's an acting defense secretary who's now out of the confirmation process of moving forward, and that is pretty stunning. Caitlin Collins, thank you so much. I want to bring in Barbara Starr, who is at the Pentagon. Barbara, what are you hearing about this change, and what all does this mean just in general to the Trump administration at a critical time where this is a critical role?
Well, let's step back just a minute. What we have known through most of the day today is that the acting secretary was struggling to make a decision about what he wanted to do. And what was he struggling about? Patrick Shanahan, this is part of a public record, several years ago had a very contentious divorce. He has three children. He had a family situation with an ex-wife, his wife at the time, where police had been called to the house. This is a matter of public record, assault and battery. There was information that his wife had engaged in assault and battery, that she had engaged in substance abuse. Patrick Shanahan had told the police he had never laid a hand on his wife, but the police had been called to this residence. Late yesterday, Shanahan put out a statement, as well as two of his three children, speaking about his wife, them speaking about their mother and their very difficult family situation. They had not been in touch with their mother for some time. Two of his three children being involved in that statement. So when we came in today, we knew that Shanahan, described by one of his closest aides, was in a bad space. He did not want to put his children through this public situation where they might have to speak more publicly, where he might have to speak more publicly in a confirmation hearing about something that was intensely personal to his family. By all accounts, he was looking at all of this and deciding throughout today whether he wanted to put his children through that again. That's where we are right now on our understanding of the situation. But on the broader national security stage, Here's the situation. He is the acting Secretary of Defense. He is scheduled to travel to NATO in the coming days for a defense ministerial. He is scheduled to travel back to Asia, which has been a top priority for him. The Iran situation heats up by the day, talking to allies about that, trying to get other countries in the Middle East to also engage in deterrence activities against Iran. How long he will stay in this acting position, we don't know. Will he stay until a new secretary is confirmed? And how long that may take may put all of this way behind schedule, Brianna.
All right, Barbara Starr, if you can stand by for me there at the Pentagon, I want to bring in John Kirby, retired Rear Admiral, former spokesperson in the Obama Pentagon and the Obama State Department. This is perhaps not completely unforeseen at this point in time. We had wondered what was going to happen with Patrick Shanahan and if this process of him going from acting Secretary of Defense to a confirmation process was going to go forward. But what is your reaction to this?
Well, certainly on the face of it, sounds like he did the right thing for his family. And I think I would suspect that his concern over his former wife also probably weighed into this. There was, in the statements of the children, mentioned that she might suffer some mental issues. And so maybe he was also trying to look after her, too. So it sounds like he's done the right thing for the family. But remember, Brianna, he'd never really been nominated. It was an intent to nominate, and that was 6 or 7 weeks ago. And we had stories yesterday about FBI checks not being complete. So it almost, I don't want to sound conspiratorial, but it sounds like maybe there was more to it than just, hey, I'm looking after the family. So we'll have to see
where this... That signaled to you that there was something awry.
He was the Deputy Secretary of Defense and then acting for a long time since Mattis resigned, and yet he still, these FBI checks weren't complete. That is not normal. There's probably just something there, and maybe that also helped lead him to this decision. Maybe he just determined it was going to be too hard to get through a confirmation battle.
Anyone in government will tell you, you need to have a Secretary of Defense. The acting thing is a problem for the Trump administration. The acting thing is especially a problem when it comes to the defense secretary. So let's talk about who's now going to be the next acting, and then we'll talk about moving forward from there. Tell us about Mark Esper. He's the Secretary of the Army. What is he going to bring to this?
I don't really know the man well, but from people I've talked to in the Pentagon, he's well-regarded, well-respected. He's done an able job as Secretary of the Army, which is, of course, the largest service. And so we'll have to see. We'll have to see what his priorities are. But even he will be acting for a while, and you're right about it being problematic when you're in the midst of these huge tensions with Iran, Russia and China, all over the world, and the allies and partners need to know that they're talking to somebody who's Senate confirmed, who has the voice and the ear of the President of the United States, and frankly, Mr. Shanahan suffered from that a little bit.